Prince Harry steps out for the first time since going public with Meghan to launch a mental health partnership with the MOD before handing out awards to employers helping veterans. Prince Harry has returned to royal duties after arriving back from the Invictus Games in Toronto, where he made his first official appearance with girlfriend Meghan Markle. The royal, 33, started the day by joining Defence Secretary Sir Michael Fallon to announce a mental health partnership with the Ministry of Defence, which will aim to tackle the hidden scars of mental illness within the armed forces. The pair later attended an event at the Imperial War Museum in London, where they presented the Employer Recognition Scheme Gold Awards to organisations which have supported members of the armed forces and their families. The Prince, who has worked tirelessly to campaign for better treatment of servicemen, veterans and their families, looked smart at both events in a suit but had time to change his tie between the two appearances. Earlier today, Harry and Sir Michael came together to launch the partnership between the Ministry of Defence and the Royal Foundation of the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and Prince Harry. Speaking at the Ministry of Defence in London, the men revealed how the programme will teach soldiers that dealing with mental health is just as important as learning new combat skills. The former army captain and Sir Michael Fallon made the case that mental fitness is as important as physical fitness when it comes to fighting wars, adding that troops should be encouraged to use psychology in the same way as athletes do to maximize performance. The Royal Foundation of the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and Prince Harry will provide advice and resources to the Ministry of Defence to improve training and education for veterans and those serving in the armed forces. Announcing the partnership, Sir Michael said, "By looking after our mental health, we are building a more effective armed forces that helps keep this country safe. Our soldiers, sailors and airmen are the best in the world, but we will only maintain that if we are as serious about improving mental health as we are our combat skills and cutting-edge technology. So partnering with key groups like the Royal Foundation is an important part of our strategy to improve the well-being of our serving armed forces and veterans." Today's joint initiative comes after Prince Harry gave an extraordinarily frank interview about coping with his mother's death earlier this year. He said he had hoped to help smash the stigma and start a national conversation about mental health. Rates of mental disorder are slightly lower in the armed forces at 3.2% than in the general population at 3.5%, but the MOD has made it a major priority. "Troops will be encouraged to use psychology and well-being in the same way as athletes do to maximize performance. Resources will be integrated into staff training courses and briefing processes across the armed forces from the middle of 2018. They will also be widely available online to strengthen the mental health support and services already available to defence personnel," Sir Keith Mills, chairman of the Royal Foundation, said. "We are delighted that this new partnership with the Ministry of Defence will see the UK leading the way internationally in prioritising the mental fitness of its entire defence community." A survey published last week found a total 1.5 million more people, 3%, were talking about mental health in May compared to February 2017. There was also a 12% increase in the number of those admitting to talking about their own mental health.